Good morning. Our opening song is page 537. Sing a new song. Page 537. Sing a new song unto the Lord, let a song ye sound from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, sing hallelujah. Yahweh, speak, O dance for joy, O come before the Lord, and play for me on their tambourines, and let your trumpets sound. Sing a new song unto the Lord, let your song
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who in the amazement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Hear this word, O children of Israel, that the Lord pronounces over you, over the whole family that I brought up from the land of Egypt. You alone have I favored more than all the families of the earth. Therefore, I will punish you for all your crimes. The two walk together unless they have agreed. Does a lion roar in the forest when there is no prey? Does a young lion cry out from its den unless it has seized something? Is a bird brought to earth by a snare when there is no lure for it? Does a snare spring up from the ground without catching anything? If the trumpet sounds in a city, will the people not be frightened? If evil befalls a city, has not the Lord caused it? Indeed, the Lord God does nothing without revealing his plan to his servants, the prophets. The lion roars, who will not be afraid? The Lord God speaks, who will not prophesy? I brought upon you such a fever as when God overthrew Sodom and Gomorrah. You were like a brand plucked from the fire. Yet you return not to me, says the Lord. So now I will be with you in my own way, O Israel. And since I will be thus with you, prepare to meet your God, O Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Lead me in your justice, Lord.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
At dawn, I bring my plea expectantly before you, for you, O God, delight not in wickedness, no evil man remains with you. The arrogant may not stand in your sight. You hate all evildoers, you destroy all who speak falsely. The bloodthirsty and the deceitful, the Lord abhors.
Amen. Your justice, Lord.
But I, because of your abundant mercy, will enter your house. I will worship at your holy temple in fear of you, O Lord.
Amen. Your justice, Lord.
They came and woke him, saying, Lord, save us, we are perishing. He said to them, why are you terrified, O you of little faith? Then he got up, rebuked the winds in the sea, and there was great calm. The men were amazed and said, what sort of man is this, even whom the winds and the sea obey? The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
The death of my father was one of the biggest storms in my life. And then 4 months after, my mother passed away, just a shy of several months from my ordination. And then 4.5 years ago, I was diagnosed with thyroid cancer, and I experienced storms in my life. And I wonder, what's the biggest storm that you have experienced in your life? In today's gospel, Jesus calmed the violent storm. And then the disciples said, even the waves in the sea obeyed him. The context of today's gospel is that Jesus had just delivered a sermon in the mount, and all were in awe because of his wonderful teaching. And then he taught the people and his disciples how to pray, to have confidence in God. Then Jesus is approached by a leper seeking for healing. And Jesus performed healing and miracles right there. And then the centurion approached Jesus to heal his servant. Again, instant miracle and healing took place. Then finally, Jesus enters the boat with his disciples, and he invited them to go and cross the sea, and a violent storm came upon them. And then the disciples began to panic, fear for their lives, and so they cried out, Jesus, do something, we are about to die. And Jesus was really surprised by the action of his disciples. Surprised because right before the violent storm, Jesus just taught them how to pray. They witnessed, they were present, physically present, and witnessed the healings that took place. They saw it in their naked eye. They have witnessed the power, the authority of Jesus. And yet, they panicked. They feared for their lives because of the violent storm. So Jesus said to them, "O you of little faith, how many miracles, how many teachings should I show you so that you have this faith in me?" And so Jesus broke the rock and he stood up and went like this: "Be calm to the violent storm." And in awe, the disciples said, "Even the waves and the violent sea obeyed me." My friends, unfortunately, it's part of our condition to experience violent storms in our lives, such as separation from another one, or a broken relationship, or divorce, or losing a job, or losing a home, unable to retire, or no money for retirement. We experience violence, death, illness, and death, because it's part of our human condition. But no matter how violent the storm that we encounter in our lives, be reminded that the God we worship has the power to calm violent storms in our lives. Jesus is telling us, have faith in me. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us all stand. For the church, may the Father of all mercies grant her members the grace to grow in love and faith. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For public authorities, may God be their guide in leading their communities with concern for the common good. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in ill health, may the healing power of Jesus bring them relief and consolation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For St. Padre Pio community, may the Lord help us live as witnesses to his saving power. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our beloved dead, may they soon enter into the fullness of God's kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord. And today's Mass is offered for Socorro and Rufino Gutierrez, for Juan Jose Guerra, Marie Azo, and all the departed poor souls in purgatory. We pray to the Lord. Let us pause in silence for our personal needs. We pray to the Lord. Father, we entrust all of these prayers to you, and we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, who will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation. For through your goodness I receive the wine we offer you. Through the divine work of human hands will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Let us all stand and pray, sister and brother, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord satisfy for the praise and glory of me, for our beautiful good fortune.
O God, who graciously accomplish the effects of your mysteries, grant we pray that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of the sacred gifts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen. Amen.
Lift up your hearts.
Amen.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
This is right, right.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, your Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our prayers, yet our thanksgiving itself your gift. Since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you with joy. Together we say, Holy,
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 Holy
Lord, God of hosts.
Heaven and earth are full of your glory, O Son of God. Bless you, O Father, in the name of the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take it, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, and all your faithful. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that may the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her chaste spouse, be the Blessed Apostles, Padre Pio, and all the saints who have visited throughout the ages, we may marry them for heirs to eternity, and may praise and glorify them through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
together with Jesus, let us glorify God, our Father, and we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that for the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of the Lord,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace in you, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
Every Lord, Spirit.
Let us offer to each other's Christ's peace. Peace be with you. Peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world. Grant us.
Lamb of God,
who take away the sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Our communion songs are 86, O Lord, and that you are the 86, O Lord. You love.
I have forgotten to mention that violent storms in our lives can cause spiritual, emotional, physical damage. But let us ask sufficient grace from God so that we can rise above the challenges and the pains and the storms in our lives. Let us all stand and pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth and ask us.
Thanks be to God.
You're most welcome to join us in the Eucharistic adoration.
Listen, you.
Son of the Holy Spirit. Amen.